discuss few pointers on problem solving. So when you solve problems on fluid dynamics, you are automatically assuming that it is a laminar flow. Point number one. Okay? Point number one, please write down, you are assuming it is a laminar flow, unless stated otherwise. Okay? Point number two. How many equations you have? A1 V1 equal to A2 V2 and P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho GH1 is constant. So you are going to use only these two equations, nothing else. So what you should do? You should not think on which equation to use. Oh, very complicated. You don't have anything else. Just two equations. Are you getting it? How to use these two equations? You should know between which two points you are applying these two equations. Are you getting it? Between which two points you are applying? You should know where is my point number one, where is my point number two. Are you getting it? So if you know it, you can apply these equations. Alright? And most of the time, you are just playing around with these two equations only. You don't need to worry about anything else. And the numericals will be straightforward. If you understand these few things with respect to problem solving, you are going to get any numerical in this topic. And why only couple of things I have talked about in problem solving? Because there are no other things to talk about. There are just these couple of things that you need to take care of. Okay? Now I just ask you a question. Tell me, the water flows from higher pressure to lower pressure? All of you understand this? Okay. Now tell me, the tap of the water is below the tank. Tank is at the top floor. Tap of the water is on the second floor or third floor, let us say. Okay. So pressure on the tap is more or less than the pressure on the tank. Pressure on the tap is more, right? P, yeah. Atmospheric pressure plus rho GH. Your tap is here, tank is there. So P plus rho GH is the pressure at the tap. Are you getting it? So water should flow from tap to the tank. Pressure at the tap is more. How come water is coming out from the tap? You have to use only, see, I told you, right, problem solving steps, you have to use only these two. Don't introduce any other concept. This is the outcome of whatever you are saying. Tell me what is happening. Or just use a basic principle that from water should flow from higher pressure to lower pressure only. Higher pressure at the tap, yes or no, you said lower pressure at the tank, so water should flow from here to there. So what is the problem? Correct. So we have chosen the two points wrongly. When you close the tap, pressure at the tap is more than the pressure at the tank. Okay? But you are not taking those two points. When the water is flowing, water is coming out. So your second point is outside the tap. First point is inside the tap. So inside the tap, pressure is very high. Outside the tap, pressure is atmospheric pressure. So that is why water comes out. Alright? So at times, you need to be taking care of these finer things when you solve numericals. So you should be knowing exactly which two points you are talking about. So just choosing two points itself is at times tricky. Alright? So just solve a couple of numericals, you will understand that what to do and when to do. So let us take few numericals now. Don't Okay, here is the situation. Water of density, let's say rho, is filled inside a tank. It is filled inside a tank up to a height of y1. There is a hole at a depth h from the top, which is at a distance y2 from below. The area of the hole is a2, area of the container is a1. Getting it? So what will happen? Water will come out from here. Let's say this velocity is v2. I am interested in finding velocity v2. What is about the? About the?
Next to A2.
Yeah, this I have shown the cross section like this. Atmospheric pressure, PA. Tell me which two points you will be applying Bernoulli's theorem? One point should you take here? You can take, no point, no problem. You can take here as well as one point outside. Okay? You can connect it with a streamline and you can say that along the streamline I am applying the Bernoulli's theorem between, let's say, point 1 and this is point 2. It is fine. Okay? Now apply Bernoulli's theorem. So, two equations you need to write, continuity equation and Bernoulli's equation. Okay? And then show it to me. Don't solve it right now. No. Don't take V1 as 0. V2. Everything you need to talk. First do it yourself, then I'll discuss. That line I have drawn, that is streamline, okay? That is one of the streamlines. Along the streamline only I can choose any two points. So I'm assuming you guys have written those two equations. The equation looks like this. A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. Okay? And what? P plus, pressure here is P. P plus half into rho into V, yeah, we want it, yeah? Okay. V1 square plus rho G. You can take H if you are assuming this to be zero gravitational potential energy. Okay? If you are assuming this to be your reference line, you have to take Y1. If you take that to be your reference line, you can directly take H. Okay? It is fine. So right now I am taking the bottom one, so this is rho g y1, this is equal to what?
PA.
And outside pressure is PA plus half rho v2 square plus rho g y2. Now I have to find v2. So first step I will write v1 in terms of v2. Okay? So from equation 1, V1 is A2 by A1 times V2. Okay? So I'll substitute the value. P plus half into rho times A2 by A1 whole square into V2 square plus, now I'll take it this side, it'll become rho G Y1 minus Y2, which is H. This is equal to P A plus half rho into V2 square. Understood? I have taken this, that side, it becomes rho g y minus y2, which is h. So I will get half of rho into V2 square into 1 minus A2 square by A1 square is equal to P minus PA plus rho GH. Don't worry about how complicated the expression is, because you just need to rearrange it. There is nothing, I mean, just that expression has too many variables, but you're not doing anything extraordinary. So so V2 square 1 minus A2 by A1 whole square is 2 times P minus PA by rho plus GH. Getting it? How is what? How is what?
Sir, you put that as y equation. That is as y.
No, no, no. Guys, pay attention. I am taking rho g y2 that side. So it becomes rho g y1 minus rho g y2. So it becomes rho g y1 minus y2. Y1 minus y2 is h. So v2, shh. Keep quiet. V2 will be square root of p minus pa plus 2gh, square root of this and 1 minus a2 minus a2 by a1 the whole square to the power minus half. 2gh will come, na? You cross multiply 2, so 2p minus pa into 2 rho gh, and then rho will be going in denominator, so rho will get cancelled away. Do it yourself, you will understand. Don't copy it. Do it yourself. So all the expression is complicated, but we have just followed whatever the equation says. Okay? Is this understood? Understood? Now tell me, if A1 is very large compared to A2, as in the whole area is very less, which is generally the case, right? Area of the hole is very less compared to the size of the container, okay? Then I can ignore A2 by A1 or not? Compared to 1, I can ignore A2 by A1. So this term will be vanished. 1 minus a2 by a1 whole square will be 1 only. Yeah. If this is the case. All of you understand that? And if container is open to atmosphere. If container is open to atmosphere, then what will happen? The pressure at the top of the water is PA only. So P minus PA will be 0. So even that term will be gone. Only thing remaining is 2GH. So velocity of efflux will come out to be under root of 2GH. This is called Torricelli's law. I hope the spelling is correct. These scientists have different kind of spelling. Kya ho gaya? Everything all right? Is okay? Whatever. Everything all right? Understood? So in your school UTs, this can come as kind of derivation of Torricelli's law. They'll ask you to derive Torricelli's law. So this is how you have to do it. We have taken it like a numerical, because it should be like a numerical, but it can come as a derivation also. Understood? No doubt, right? We'll go to the next page. Tell me one thing. If you are, you will be more interested in finding the velocity of the water or how much water is coming per second?
How much
water, right? You can always increase or decrease the velocity by narrowing the cross-section area. But you cannot change the mass per unit time that is coming to you. dm by dt will be constant. Are you getting it? So that is why the rate of flow of water is a more important parameter than the velocity of the water. Fine? Now, when we talk about rate of flow of water, dm by dt is what I am saying. dm by dt is what? Rho A into V. This is what we have derived earlier itself. So rho AV, write down, is mass per unit second, kg per second. Okay? And if density is constant throughout, I can calculate just A into V. This is what? Volume flow rate. This much meter cube per second is flowing. A into V. This is also represented by letter capital Q. So these are just terminologies that you are going to see when you solve numericals. So don't get confused. Volumetric flow rate is area of cross section into volume, which is meter cube per second, and mass flow rate is rho into A into V, which is kg per second. What? That's what I said, na? Q is volumetric flow rate.
Sir, we can use this thing for some volumetric first.
You can use it anywhere, whenever it is required. There is nothing wrong if you use it, but you may not get the answer which you are looking for. It is like you are asking whether we can use force equal to mass and acceleration. It is a law, you can use it anywhere. Right? But you may or may not get what you are looking for. Suppose you have to find velocity, but if you use force into mass and acceleration, you get acceleration. But you are interested in finding velocity, right? Okay, can I proceed?